who are hurting. We're a harbor for those who are lost. Sometimes it's not always easy bearing Calvary's cross. We've been ridiculed by those who don't know him, and mocked by those who don't believe.
Good morning, everybody. Our first reading is taken from 2 Timothy 1 verse 10. And it reads as follows: He has saved us and called us to a holy life, not because of anything we have done, but because of his own purpose and grace. This grace was given us in Christ Jesus before the beginning of time. But it has now been revealed through the appearing of our Saviour, Christ Jesus, who has destroyed death and has brought life and immortality to light through the gospel. And verse 12 reads as, Yet this is no cause for shame, because I know whom I have believed, and am convinced that is able to guard what I have entrusted to him until that day. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
Embarrassment, shame, guilt. We could all share different experiences when we felt these emotions. Sometimes it's funny, and sometimes it's not. As we read through the New Testament, we are warned and encouraged not to let the temptation of being ashamed of or being embarrassed about our Saviour get the better of us. Oddly enough, an obstacle that often hinders our effectiveness as Christians is shame. We become embarrassed to be associated with Jesus Christ and other Christians, whether it be by peer pressure or by the unfortunate acts or situations of few people. We feel shame because of who we are and what we stand for. There are times when we are made to feel shame and embarrassment about our God. When bad things happen, people question, where was God? If God is so good, then why did this evil happen? Jesus gives us a very stern warning against being ashamed of God. If anyone is ashamed of me and my words in this adulterous and sinful generation, the Son of Man will be ashamed of him when he comes in his Father's glory with the holy angels. Mark 8 verse 38. God knows we are not perfect. We are not a perfect generation, and we should not be ashamed of him. No one is too bad to have a relationship with God or to share his relationship with God. The reason that we are easily tempted to become ashamed about God and ashamed and fearful to tell others about him is because we don't know God well enough. Our relationship with God is more of an acquaintance than of a dear friend and father. Paul was not ashamed to testify and tell others about God, as he writes in verse 12. We live in a time when the shameful feel no shame for their deeds. Instead, the one who stands for truth is the one shamed. The one who stands for Christ as Saviour and Lord of all is the one shamed. Just as Jesus said it would be. Don't let shame get in the way of your growing faith and relationship with Christ. Don't let it stunt your effectiveness. In order to become an effective Christian, we must not be ashamed of telling others about God, guiding the gospel of Christ, and supporting troubled Christians. Because as we read in verse 10, it has now been revealed through the appearing of our Saviour, Christ Jesus, who has destroyed death and has brought life and immortality to light through the gospel. This is a call for faithfulness. This is a call for you to stand strong and firm in your faith. Do not be ashamed, because everything has been revealed. Amen.
Let us pray. Father, forgive us for being ashamed of the gospel. Forgive us for those times when we have not shared the very truth that has saved us. We repent of all fear of witnessing to our faith in the Lord Jesus Christ. I pray for all in our church and people everywhere that they might be so committed to Jesus that they might never be ashamed of him. Help them to gladly identify with him, both in his sufferings and in his victories. May we never be intimidated by our peers. Please deliver us from those habitual sins that condemn our conscience and make us feel so unworthy of telling others of Jesus' grace and power. May we be such lovers of the gospel that we are eager to share it both in word and deed. Teacher God, I pray that I will never be ashamed of the gospel. I pray, God, that you give me the chance to share the gospel with others, no matter who they are. Give me the power and courage to share my faith with others and prepare their hearts to receive. In Jesus' name, amen.
We're a harbor for those who are lost. Sometimes it's not always easy bearing Calvary's cross. We've been ridiculed by those who don't know him, and mocked by those who don't believe. Still I love standing up for my Jesus, 'cause of all that he's done for me. That's why I am not ashamed of the gospel, the gospel of Jesus Christ. For every moment his hand has had mercy, for all the love he's shown in my life. A simple thanks just doesn't say how I'm feeling. I get tears in my eyes. So as for me, I'm gonna keep on believing in the one who's been so faithful to me. I'm not out to please this whole world around me. Oh, I've got my mind